In today's video, we are inspecting a first edition Legend of Blue Eyes WAVY box to see if it's legit. What's up, guys? We are back with another video where this is going to be a pretty interesting one. We're going to be opening up a first edition WAVY box to see if the packs inside are actually legit. I have some concerns with this box, and I'm worried that it could be resealed. And this is a really important one because we're going to be opening that box on Friday on Whatnot for a box break. So I'm really hoping that it's legit. So we're opening it up, checking out the packs, making sure it's real before we actually go live. Because if we go live, we open it up and it's resealed, the whole stream goes up in smoke. It's just like screwed. So we want to find out ahead of time if they're legit. Then we can do all the auctions and feel good about the box. And I'm also going to be showing you guys a bunch of items that we're going to have available on Whatnot this Thursday and Friday because we're doing two streams. There's one for the new Bonanza set, which is going to be bananas. And then the next day we're doing one for the LOB first edition WAVY box. And then we're completing the entire Bonanza set on Saturday on YouTube. So three straight days, three straight streams, awesomeness. It's going to be probably our biggest streaming weekend ever in terms of like big product and new stuff and old stuff. So make sure you guys check it out. All right. So before we hop into it, we have a giveaway. I'll be giving away these two cards. We have Gear Free, the Ion Knight. This is both PSV and the Secret Rare from the BPT. Just like the video, be subscribed, turn on notifications. Let me know down below. What do you think about this WAVY box? We've never opened one on the channel, by the way. And let's get to it. All right, guys, today we are going to be checking out a first edition Legend of Blue Eyes WAVY box. So this was supposed to be a Whatnot stream and hopefully still will be a Whatnot stream coming up, but I have suspicions about this box. So we got the box in and taking a look at it, if you guys can tell, the top is a little bit bowed up, kind of like it doesn't fit in the box, which happens a lot with current Yu-Gi-Oh boxes, but not so much with the originals. Like with the originals, that's pretty unusual and not usually a good sign. So it's kind of bulging out, which is not a good sign. This is the first edition WAVY. You can tell by the smaller text there. It is a real box. You can see that's the WAVY text. Smaller text means WAVY, bigger text means glossy. The Konami logo is not touching in the O and the N. If those two are touching, that means it's a counterfeit box. That is always foolproof. It's always right. This is a real box, so that's a good sign. The problem is, we're not worried about a legitimate box, we're worried about a reseal. So, weird part about this one is it's a little open, which is like, well, that could be a good way to reseal it if it's already partially open. I don't know. I've heard from other people, they don't usually see, reseals with flaps. So that could be a good for us on our side. We're really hoping these are real and we can sell them on the Whatnot stream later, but we want to make sure it isn't filled with something else. So it also has a kind of a weird feeling to it. It was purchased by a couple of viewers during COVID, which makes me a little nervous because during COVID, I mean, resales were rampant because obviously it's like people know there's a lot of money in this stuff. So I'm worried a little bit. I'm worried a little bit that that happened. So basically the signs we can see is there's no little perforations around the edge or little wrinkles around the edge, which you tend to see on a real box. So really there's no real reason to slow this down. So let's just go ahead and open this up right now and see. And I'm just really hoping this is like the real packs in here. We can just, we open the box on video. It'll still be basically a sealed box we're selling. It just won't be at the time. So this being opened is pretty weird too. So let's just try to, maybe if I pull at this, it'll show something. Okay, it goes like that. All right, so we're opening this. Very expensive box, by the way. This is why we're, doing videos and stuff like that about if it's real or not. The wrap, though, feels good. That feels good. So that's could be original wrap. Let's see about the rest of the box. Okay, wait a second. This is looking okay right now. Let's see. All right, wait a second. This might be real. This might be real. It looks like it is, honestly. The only thing to worry about at this point is if they somehow like weighed packs or something and then put them back in. But nobody that reseals would do that. Maybe, I'm wondering why, is there any reason why, let's count the packs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, it's a normal number. Why these are not fully fitting in the box. They feel good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I think this is a real box. Why do they not? This could be a WAVY versus glossy thing. I've never actually had a WAVY box. I've bought a couple glossy boxes. I've opened a couple glossy boxes or a few glossy boxes at this point, and they feel different than this. And I'm wondering if that is why. But as you can tell, like, look at this. These packs don't really fit in this box. And that is not normal for a glossy box. Though this is a wavy box, so that might be why. They see, as you can tell, like, look at this. See how it kind of is up a little bit on the edge? But it looks like, from what I can tell, this thing is actually legit, which is great news for our Whatnot stream Friday. So we'll actually make this a video and, you know, talk about the stream coming up on Friday. So we're going to actually be breaking this box. I'm going to try to seal this with something. I used to have some of those. I don't want to mess up the box, though. Maybe if I... All right, guys. So I actually feel like this is real. So we're going to put this back in the wrap just so I don't have to tape onto the box because, you know, the box is cool. I'm going to tape this on there. We'll put... What's the date right now? We'll put 11/3/24 on there. Verified. So... this is the box we're going to be opening up. We're going to leave that piece of tape on there until we open this thing on Friday. So this is going to be a really cool stream. I'm really happy this is real because I was like 90% sure this thing was fake. So that's the thing about reseals and like sealed product and stuff. You can never really know. And this stinking thing is up here like this, whatever. You know, we'll keep that tape on there. So I'm excited. I'm really pumped that this is legit. And I'm happy for the guys who sent it to me because it was going to suck if it was resealed. So very cool. So I'll see you guys on Friday for this opening. This is going to be really cool. This week is the Whatnot Card Show, the largest card show on the planet. Not only are we opening Yu-Gi-Oh's most hyped set in a very long time, the Quarter Century Bonanza, which includes over 900 different cards. And that will be on Thursday, by the way. We're also opening a first edition WAVY Legend of Blue Eyes booster box. Yeah, we've never opened a WAVY box before. I have also opened and verified that there are first edition Legend of Blue Eyes WAVY packs inside. This will be open on Friday on Whatnot. No one has ever pulled a WAVY Blue Eyes White Dragon on camera before, so this could be the very first time. And not only will we be opening these awesome products, we'll be giving away a Buster Blader 2003-10 on both streams. So you guys could win a 2003 Buster Blader 10 and many, many more on these streams. And did I forget to mention something? Oh, $15 free money on Whatnot. So if you want to buy anything on the Thursday or Friday stream, which both start at 4 p.m. Central, check your daylight savings time. You know, it'll be on the app. So just go bookmark the show so you don't, you know, have any weird daylight savings times and miss an hour, because you wouldn't want to do that on these big streams. But you get to use that $15 free credit. We will also still have a few of our Magia mats still available. So massive Whatnot week coming up. I hope to see you guys there. It's going to be so much fun. Thanks again to Whatnot for sponsoring this video. All right, that box looks like it's actually going to be legit, so super exciting for Friday. Let's run through a few other things on this beautiful Pequeno Moth mat. We've shown both mats in this video. The Magia mat is still available. The Pequeno Moth, gone for good. If you missed it, sorry guys, that's it. Magia mat, though, is still available on Whatnot, so don't miss out. It's selling out as we speak, and once it does sell out, gone for good. All right, let's go through a few nice items. We have... I always say Command Knight on this guy. Total Defense Shogun 10 from 2004. These will all be available on my Whatnot store for the streams. They're going to be available probably early or on my marketplace already anyway, if you want to go grab them now. I'm going to show you guys a bunch of these things that you guys can get. We've got another one, which is the Blade Knight, which is one of my favorites because of GOAT formats. It's really decent. And speaking of GOAT, Bonanza just reprinted so many great GOAT cards. It's going to make it so easy to build a really pretty GOAT deck, which is pretty cool. I have one more Raviel, Lord of Phantasm Sin. I had a few of these. We're down to only one left. So one more Raviel 10. Very cool. It's a Sacred Beast, 2006, so very awesome. And speaking of very awesome, in 2004, like those 10s earlier, we have an Invasion of Chaos original box. It's not a 25th anniversary. This is the OG. This has the red Konami logo, which is the second logo that used to be the little banner swishy one. Then they changed it. Well, I guess this is kind of a banner logo. I don't know. But the swishy one in the square, and now they have this sort of more banner red one. And then, not now. Now it's completely different, but this is the old one from 2004. So as you guys can see, it's like just like an old school booster box. It's just not first edition or anything. But I have not one, but two of these. I don't know if one is one of these. Are they both? I think they're both CED boxes, right? Yeah, so they're both CED boxes. So because it's a 24-pack box. In IOC, they did both retail and hobby in 24-packs. So one is Invader Darkness, one is Chaos Emperor Dragon. But both of these are the Chaos Emperor Dragon code, which is this for unlimited. This is the unlimited code. So you guys want any of those, they will be available as well. And speaking of buying stuff on Whatnot, if you guys have already bought things and you have like the bronze tier and silver tier and all that stuff, it gives you a bunch of savings on Whatnot as well. And if you're a new user, you get $15 off. So there's a lot of ways to get discounts over there. We have one more 2005 10, which is the Panther Warrior. It's got a little rip in it. So if you guys want to make me an offer on that one or whatnot or whatever, then feel free to do that. Then we have a bunch of PSA cards. I actually got a PSA collection that I did not post. So this is like a secret PSA collection you guys can see. This part is not actually part of it. I'll tell you when it starts, but here's some other cards I have available. So Widespread Ruin, we got this at Collecticon. Archlord Christia, this is the one we pulled and it got a little ding on the corner by PSA, which was really sad. Where's the corner? There it is. Bottom right corner, so it has a pretty bad corner, but it was pulled by me. That's really the only issue. It would have been a PSA 10 if he hadn't damaged it. Really sad that happened. Future Fusion, this is another one. I picked this one up. I just bought it off a guy who graded it. Very cool ultimate rare card. So that card is available as well. Then we've got some high-end ones as well. We've got stuff like a Magnificent Mavens, Secret Pharaoh Rare, Dark Magician Girl. Very cool PSA 10 right there. There is a Metamorphosis, which I have, someone has offered me, but they have not yet accepted. They offered, I accepted, and they haven't replied. So if that doesn't go through, this will be available. If it does, then this won't be available, but it's a Metamorphosis from Champion Pack, so very cool. A Twin-Headed Behemoth, pretty awesome PSA 10. It's just a super rare, nothing crazy. Takaminos from McDonald's Pack, one of my favorite ever sets. You guys know that with the Millennium Shield and all. Luminous Soldier, this is a TP Ultra, TP5, probably the most common, definitely the cheapest of the TP Ultras, but a very nice way to start your TP Ultra collection if you're going to get one. Breaker, speaking of TP, this is TP7, PSA 10. I once sold this to Ian, fan of the channel, he then sold it back to me, or we consigned it, then I bought all the consignment off of him eventually, or the, everything we had left, so that is now back in my possession, which is interesting. Needleworm, another TP card, also from TP5, actually more expensive than the Ultra because it's Needleworm, very cool. A lot of this is on the sleeve, but because it's like eBay authenticated, I'm just not gonna open it, so when you get it, you can open that up and put a new sleeve on it or something. Access Code Talker, PSA 10, this is the Starlight Rare, not the QCR, so harder to pull, you know, it's from BLCR, so it's one per case on that one instead of one per two cases, but still a lot harder than QCRs are now. We have a Cyber Dark Dragon. This one is sort of pending. Someone has said they're gonna buy it. I'm still waiting on that to actually happen. So this is probably not available, but who knows? If that falls through, it could be. Then we have a Dark Paladin. That is a PSA 10 Ultra Rare from Magician's Force. So this is the error artwork. They accidentally put this one in, also eBay authenticated. So it was supposed to be the unlimited artwork. You guys know the story, but instead of the unlimited artwork, they accidentally put all of this artwork into the boxes. This is the Duel Master's Guide. Duel Master's Guide, right? This is the Duel Master's Guide artwork versus the unlimited is what it should be. So it's technically an error, but really it's not. It's in every single box, like, so it's kind of normal. It just wasn't intended. So very cool, really pretty artwork. Then we have a few graded, only a few graded packs left. We have a Magician's Force First Edition, which is obviously a big one, because it's Magician's Force, everybody loves that. There is a TP6, which is, you know, tournament pack, so pretty cool. And then another pretty awesome one, the Invasion of Chaos First Edition PSA 10. So three PSA 10 graded packs. If you were interested in all three, I could definitely give a deal. And then we have the cards I have left from this PSA purchase. There was some really cool stuff in there. Some of it is sold, some of it is not. So let's just kind of run through it. So here's some Gem at 10 Chaos End Master, Fog King PSA 10, Injection Fairy Lily from Retro Pack 2 Ultra Rare. All this is going to be available. Hellpoimer, that's a PSA 10 Retro Pack 2. My Insect Queen from Retro Pack, that's PSA 9. PSA 10 Jam Defender, PSA 10 Buster Blader. A LOB reprint, like 2017, PSA 9, which is actually pretty hard to get 10s on those. So 9 is really not that bad, because you guys remember I graded a bunch of those. It was really a long time ago, but we got a bunch of 8s and 7s. So a 9 is really not that bad. Then we have a Hamon, Lord of Striking Thunder, Secret Rare. A Volcanic Doomfire. These are Mega 10s, or what do they call them? Collectible 10s back then. Cyber Dark Dragon, the Ultra. So we have Ultra and Ulti Cyber Dark Dragon available. Cyber Dragon, Super Rare. This is an Unlimited from CRV. Ancient Fairy Dragon, really pretty Ultimate Rare PSA 10. Ancient Fairy Dragon, really, really pretty Ghost Rare PSA 9. Not a PSA 10, but still really, really nice. I mean, it looks amazing in the slab. Black Rose Dragon PSA 9. This is the Ultimate Rare Unlimited. Also really, really awesome. Blue Eyes White Dragon PSA 8. SDK. There's another PSA 8 Blue Eyes. There's a Cyber Blader Ultimate Rare. Dark Nephthys PSA 9. Elemental Hero Thunder Giant PSA 10. Elemental Hero Chaos Neos PSA 10 Secret Rare. Divine Neos PSA 9. That's an Unlimited. There is an PSA 10 Unlimited Divine Neos. Tempest Magician from Crossroads of Chaos PSA 10. Retiari, which by the way is from Crossroads of Chaos. A lot of people don't know that. PSA 9. Gladiator Beast MRD Reprint PSA 10. Gladiator Beast Gate Guardian. Just saw a gladiator beast, and I said it again. And then a winged Karibo level 9. So as you can see, we have a lot of cool stuff there, a lot of variety. That's not everything we'll have available. That's just some of the nice stuff and some stuff that you guys hadn't seen on the channel yet. So if you're interested in any of that, make sure you come out to the stream on Thursday or Friday. You don't have to even buy anything to watch the streams, though. They're just going to be a good time, especially that LOB Wavy opening. No one has ever pulled the blue eyes in Wavy first edition. So at least people have pulled it before, but not on YouTube. So if we pull it on whatnot, you know, we can post a video and everything. It'll be really, really cool. So I'm really excited for that. Hopefully you guys will be there. It's going to be two amazing streams on whatnot, Thursday, Friday, and then a big time YouTube stream Saturday, completing a 967 card set or whatever. Bonanza is going to be insane. We're going to be live like all of Saturday. So set aside your Saturday. It's going to be fun. Shout out to Tomfo Show and Nesto Diana, America Doyster, Brandon Chaney, Hextick, Ian Musa, Junior Barding, Robert F., and Changalang. Thank you guys for supporting the channel. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.